in here, my luck in here. A lot of people are connected to me. A lot of people are connected to you. But they're not connected to God. They didn't come to see God, they come to see you.
Yeah.
You have to realize that this only becomes relevant to you when you have been connected to God. He is the head of the body, who is in the beginning, the firstborn, that's what the word says, from the dead, that is in all things, that he might have preeminence. For it pleases the Father that in him dwell the fullness of the Godhead. Preeminence, things of majesty and royalty. And when they go before the queen in England, they always say, "Your eminence." And but they say here, it has preeminence. God is not only eminent, he is preeminent. He's Lord of lords and he's King of kings. What I'm trying to get you in church to understand is that what I say being grounded in the faith is not having a superficial relationship with more than religious suggestions, if you will, accoutrements or things that are etudes on your car, or having long skirts, or playing the Mahalia Jackson at home when you get there. We got a whole lot of that. And when trouble comes, you can't stand because your root don't go any deeper than the choir. You haven't been rooted, you haven't been grounded, and when trouble comes, it says it in Matthew. Y'all are reading in Matthew the 7th chapter. It says that when the storms and the rains come, that house fail, because that house was built on sand. If you don't get to, you don't understand me, because you're rooted and grounded to the stage. And if you don't get that stage, you're out of here. If you don't get your ministry, if you don't preach or you don't teach when you want, or if they don't call your ministry, they don't call your name, you're out of here. And we wonder where everybody have gone. But there are some people in the church, if they don't sing, or if they don't preach, or they don't get to the stage, they say that I will bless the Lord at all times. And in my mouth will be his praise. I will bless the Lord if I don't sing. I will bless the Lord if I don't preach. I will bless the Lord if I don't teach. And in my mouth will continually be his praise. The difference between someone who is singing for the stage or singing for the Savior. He is before all things. He's in charge. He is preeminent. God does not have preeminence, or does God have preeminence in your life?
All right.
When you're in trouble, I don't want to say, God says that preeminence is the beginning, and in him consists all things, and he is the first. God says he don't want to be last. He don't want to be that last call, but he want to be the first call. Y'all know when y'all have consulted everybody else, we have consulted everybody else, we called everybody, checked every bank account, then we call on the Lord, then we in trouble. But if God is preeminence in your life, if he's the first in your life, God says, call me early in the morning. He said, call me when your day gets started.
Yeah.
I want you to pray when you ain't got a microphone.
Yeah.
I want you to pray even when you don't know what to pray about.
Yeah.
I want you to pray when there are no cameras.
Yeah.
God says, I want you to pray before you take that job, not when you're getting ready to be laid off. In the name of Jesus, God says that I want you to ask him before you take another position. He says that in him consists all things, and by him nothing exists. God says that I want you to know that I'm before all things. Go ahead and consult mama. Go ahead and consult daddy. Keep on. I'm not saying that mama is not a consultant, but mama will fail. Daddy will fail. Your uncles will fail. Jesus, God said that he will never leave you nor forsake you. And he cannot fail. Why are you making God laugh when he asked you to make him first? For Matthew says, even in the Bible says, seek ye first. Oh, y'all hear me? The kingdom of God and all his righteousness and all those things that you desire are going to be added to you. But he says, come and seek me first. I'll give you direction. I'll tell you where to go, when to go, and how to go. Seek me first. As a matter of fact, God says that he gave you that husband. As a matter of fact, he said he gave you them children that you got. He gave you that job that you got. God says he gave you that house that you got. God says he gave you the education he got. He says that he gave you in everything that you have, and you're still making him laugh. He says that I brought you through the storm when you didn't know which way to go. He is preeminence. For it pleased the Father that in him that all fullness should dwell. I'm talking about Jesus. Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Without Jesus, you can't even access God or the Holy Spirit. I'm saying that they have an icon on your computer. If you click on Jesus, then you got the God and you got the Holy Spirit. They say he's the Trinity. It's three in one. You can't access one without the other. Everybody say Jesus.
Jesus.
Without Jesus, you can't access it. You just click on that access, and in the name of Jesus, there's power. In the name of Jesus, there's salvation. In the name of Jesus, there's deliverance. Whatever situation and circumstance you're in, there's deliverance. In the name of Jesus, there's healing. Wherever your body is aching, relaxed, and praising, and you don't know, you went to every doctor in hell, asked the lady in the Bible, she said she consulted him 38 long years. And they had one that looked for Jesus. He had spent every dime that she had. And Jesus said, there's healing in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in Philippians 2 and 6, who being in the form of God, didn't consider his robbery to be equal with God. More Bible says that God said, this is my well-beloved son, in whom I well pleased. When you're in the hospital's room and you say, in the name of Jesus, you have the Holy Spirit, you have God, and you have Jesus all there to your aid. But Jesus said that I am the truth, the way, and the life.
Yes, sir.
You can't get to God unless you go through Jesus. Try Buddha and see if you get to Jesus. In this economical society that we live in today, they don't know the difference here between me and Louis Farrakhan. They don't know the difference. In a society, when you turn on the news, they have to treat everybody equal. They got to give fair time to the Baptists, to all the religions, regardless of what they are. It's not to say I'm condemning it. I respect everybody's religion. Who receive religious documentation. Some people receive their religious documentation from the 6 o'clock news. Who have the responsibility to be equal, to make it equitable between all faiths. They say that they don't know the difference between me and Farrakhan. They see that we're black. They see that we're talking religion. They see that we're working in for community development. But I'm here to tell you, This is not no